Budget, focusing on the Raxus for now. Meanwhile, Fnatic, they're going for the full Mega Creeps here. They go bottom, then they go mid. TP back from mid one. The throne is going to be the target. Arjit wants it. He's got the rapier, he's got the butterfly. In comes the Storm Spirit, the swap back as well. Storm is the target though. He's been stunned up. Ravage number one. Mid one caught in the hex as well. Mid one goes down, immediately buying back. Where is that Medusa? In the fountain! She's been kicked in by the Earth Spirit, I can only imagine. And rapier on the ground now. Medusa going to buy back, has to TP back in, but does not have a rapier anymore. Second Ravage comes out, catches everyone, but where's the damage? Medusa with a stone gaze, is this going to be enough? The Storm gets dazed up now, taking a bit of damage on the backline, so still has plenty of mana. Higher, low as well, Nana. They've got to win this game now, they've got to go for the throne. Medusa still standing strong, as does the Jug, but Storm back in fighting at shape. Mid one, can do this on his own, he's got backup though. Lifestealer back in the fray. Ohio's pulled back on Beastmaster, and WG Unity are being repelled. They're now fighting Mega Creeps. Fnatic have held onto their throne.
Ember is very good at defending creeps, and they have a lot of auras, bench, and they have the Vlads and AC on Brutes. Possible. Maybe 20 to 30% chance, I would say.
20 to 30, that's continuing up against Mega Creeps, that's not bad, DJ. Had a Doom walk in, they had the gem, they get the swap, Arthu! He's found him! No Doom for you! Drops the gem as well on the north side, it's gonna be a high with the BKB, the egg comes out, will they focus it? It looks like the plan is to do so, but the Chrono on everyone with the Omni Slash! WG Unity clean up until Mushi says hello. First Light of Fist does a lot of damage, he's cleaving through the Mushi with the rapier! Mushi, Mushi, Mushi! Destroys WG Unity! Double kill for him. Fnatic mid one is dominating, and it looked so good for Unity with that Chronosphere, but then Mushi rocks up and just tore them apart.
Fight without it. Of course, you're gonna just be able to just play a little bit more defensively, but they still have Aegis, they still have Cheese, so that's a little bit more of an advantage, and escape is
looking for it right there.
Oh my god, they're all clumped up. Formic, Chrono!
He manages to hit all of them. Yaxel is going to be brought down here. Cinder and he can't save life this time. Coin, but all he can do is throw out Chakram's Error. Is somehow still alive in the middle of all of that. He's going to reincarnate into the hell that is his new life and only buyback. Let's see. We're going to see Error falling here very, very quickly.
He
doesn't have a buyback.
You don't want to fight without Exorcism unless you land a Man Chrono.
Raiding down the mid lane.
Okay, maybe next time leaves out the front, but he didn't even have a blink. He got spotted. Loda pulls back. Oh, but there's going to be the jump. Badara. Oh, jump lord a bit. He's out of position here. And can't find the commitment yet for the Chrono. Does
go! S4 and Bulldog. They decide to go for Bulldog instead. Can they burst him down in time? He's taking a lot of damage, but they can't finish him off yet. Vacuum right on the wall. RP has the counterplay. And my god, look at the damage fly up from Loda. Ultra kill by him as he wipes out four. Oh my goodness, Alliance say, don't you dare.
All right, Battle Fury paying off instantly.
Whoa!
Yeah. Like a minute ago. Okay, yeah, I was like, I just clicked him. I swear he didn't have that.
Yeah, it was only a short time ago.
Yeah. So that's going to be really big, especially once he gets the Guardian Greaves up, then it's the Puck Silence is going to be negligible to him because he's just going to remove it right away.
Chronosphere comes off, but no! They're not real! Both of them aren't real! Bug's going to get the Dream Coil, and they already have health ability to get out of this one, but Earthbird gets wiped on the back line, and they back him in! Madara couldn't get the perfect leave until now they line up for a Finger of Death, killing off Illidan, and Madara, Graham's son, make a sandwich of F5, Pasha. He's in trouble too. Silenced up. Nowhere to go but down. Ultra kill for Madara. And the Greeks be coming.
Crunch. That scales. Not even just like exponentially, but in more of a factor than that on the side of Alliance, where they have three heroes that benefit heavily from Empower with a max Empower.
That's Minifer coming by here. Alliance haven't been able to finish the Rose. Well, quick burst from the TA will be able to finish off Ake. Alliance could be in a bit of an awkward position here.
RP on the ready, though.
Yep, and Chrono is not. So roll forward. Spartan ditches up the Magnetize between two. Gets the Boulder Smash off. That will prevent S4 from being able to be a good blinking position. Walks through. Magnetize will reset.
they're trying their best to be able to get at least EGM bursted down. He's dropping every stone he can to be able to get it done. That, oh, connected through, almost got EGM, but it's not going to be enough. Oh, Vacuum will bring Bulldog up and right on top of a wall up and above. The Chrono locks him down.
Teammate.
Oh, no, just locking the Bulldog, and of course, the maybe next time Lion's not going to be enough, but with Bulldog still trapped on the high ground, Madara joins him, and he's just in a continuous battle with himself.
Oh, instant Hex by maybe next time.
But that Hex stops anything from having as a follow-up from Alliance. They still can't get him down. They finally will finish him off. It is going to be Darkseer who gets the credit because of the wall. Turns into a 2-for-1, and Aspidem doing their damnedest to keep him alive. But there's going to be the burst. They finally finish out the Lion. And here comes Spartan back for round number 2. Boulder Smash Silence onto S4. Madara leaps in for the follow-up play. Can they stop him from making it out? He's just going to commit the RP.
He's going to die anyway.
And boom! They'll be able to finish him off. What a wonderful comeback here from Advenom. And look at this. They'll sweep in to hopefully get the finish. But look at this. EGM. They don't have a sentry. Oh, God. He's got to be careful. The sideways came in. No! Oh, my God. Oh, no. Oh, my God. This is unbelievable. Oh, no.
We're hitting kind of like the mid-game, you could say, and it's looking very good for Fantastic Five. I still almost say Roxas just because they're BZZ.
Yeah. Hey, man, I almost say Empire when I read BZZ. Jump in from Thugs. He gets time locked as well. Gonna jump out. The Chrono's fist down there. The Aegis Immortal snatched by the Sven. He'll be locked in the Chrono at the back into the wall. Can you get some cleave here from Madara? He needs the opening, and there it is, BZZ and Illidan. They line themselves up. The Magnetite as well, looking for the control from F5. They need to get back in control of this fight, but they can't do it! Madara helps to kill off 3. The FD disruption is setting up for the 4th, and they even get the Sun on pass before the Timberchain can get him back out again. F5, they went in for Roshan, and AF reply in style.
Ghostep earlier went back and sold it, but now has an Ogre Club in buyback, it looks like.
Okay.
So it's gonna be good for the KB, and they're gonna run into XXS first. Smokes is gonna break, they would know XSS being here immediately. Oh, they got an illusion! Oh no, they even commit the Chrono for it! It's time to run, but again, you're running against Full Blink and Glimpse. It's not gonna be good. XSS is on the hunt. He's the fish, he's trying to look for something, but like, how is gonna be the first one to get found? He gets shield up, but well, they trade the event for the a tombstone, and here comes the Juggernaut. He's trying to get something done. Lin, the old club unable to really save him. And it is a disaster, as some would say.
This is not the way it was meant to be. Your Weaver is just jumping around in the back lines, trying to find anything at all, and just not going to be able to find the kills.
Yeah, that's a big problem. And it looks like Fantastic Five actually, they want to try to contest for this one.
Yeah, they actually saw the Astral Spirit up on the top lane, and then drew a direct line saying, yo guys, F5 is on this hill. So the Spirit will come in, he'll have a look inside the pit, the Mystic Snake will bounce, and she triggers the block of the off Roshan with a crush as well. Kaizu will be slowed up for a little bit. Illidan, he wants to come forward. The problem is that he cannot lose this Rapier. So starts the Stonegate, looks to snatch out the Aegis the Immortal, and he's actually, well, the kill goes to the Dire side, so Medusa will snatch the Aegis the Immortal. Now looking to pump the damage in that armor turned on Era, but the fight still splitting up with that Smith Ashley. Have they got enough damage? With the split shot, Cinderin's dropping down low, the ET split will happen. They bring down the Bear, Coinful have to resummon this one, but Era back in for the two-man crush with a double Chakram. They're burning through Illidan. BZZ has to repel and move himself away from this one while Illidan just trying to beat tower defense at the moment. Cinderin's being chased down by Pass from the back lines. Yapzor's going to help him out, but Illidan focusing the damage. Cinderin inside the pit using the Fog of War to survive, and they don't know exactly who they're trying to kill off here. With the split shot from Illidan, he just wants everyone but can't claim one. They are just splitting up this entire fight. He might get the secondary bear, but now he's actually going to lose the Rapier, and with that, he should be losing the game. The Aegis Immortal will give him more time. Relocates on the way, BZZ makes his way forward. He needs to make this perfect timing to save up Illidan, who wants to continue to battle against the rest of ESC. Push him up the hill, get him up to safety, make it so Keizu has to keep working hard for this one. The Yule's up from Keizu, keeps fighting up against Illidan, and maybe now he'll start to back off as mana drops down low. ESC are still on the run. Illidan to the front lines. Find Cinder. It's amazing what happens when he focuses his damage. Pasha gets the vision, needs the roar to actually find any kind of kill here. The Cinderin just outruns him. He's actually got better movement speed at the moment. Back to the tier 3 tower.
Breathe, Toby, breathe!
It's fine. Not required.
Non-stop.
Purged up as well. He needs just to run this off. Thanks to the Surge, he's able to do so. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. To be honest, I thought Zekra's high ground defense could be a hell of a lot better than this, but they just never, they can't. Found a good opening, now Bulba back, a four-man rabbit done with a that's what you're waiting for, but still, it's too little too late. Illidan is so fat right now, he is going to fit through the burrow door and just take down Poppy underneath his own tier 4 towers. RMN might be stunned for a bit. But Arteezy, you want to keep fighting this one? RMN just tethers himself down. Arteezy, okay, he gets the chain. They get the Gem of True Sight back again. So, a small recovery. And that was thanks to that initial kill over on the Beastmaster. BZZ lost as well. And Team Secret being pushed to the edge. They lose their mid-racks, but they hold their bottom.
Where? One team has a significantly better game than the Spectre team.
Yeah. 430 scouts out the smoking. There is the enemy team coming.
They would not accept. Oh, I hear a stun ultimate.
Go in the background. Sven just gets a quick, easy kill. They see, okay, Sylar's gonna get the stun. They're gonna haunt it immediately, and they're gonna get one quick kill. CTY now going to Sven. Actually, gonna just man fight a Sven, forcing out a TP. That's a pretty good beginning of the fight. 430 now man fighting against 3. 4 ice blocks. Pop. He does. Okay, that's pretty good. The Ravage will come out here. BKB gets popped here by 430. He's man fighting, but I think with that blast, they might actually win the man fight here. Yeah, they will win the man fight.
That was so weird for my G.
He's come through for escape in the past.
Yep.
Maybe not so much during this time, but back when they were known as No Diggity, people were banning Eddie's Faces Void in the first two just because of the fact he kept finding 4-5-man Chronos. Now he jumps in, finds S4, goes for the first one. RK will end up sacrificing his life as he swaps out S4. He will he survive. EGM gets a shallow grave. RK making himself out. This one, Bulldog hunting down Cinder and the Ghost is protected for now, but not anymore. Bulldog just reeling away. The Lotus Form is up. Yapstor actually picking himself up with this one. They Chronos Spear onto S4. Will they find the damage? Sunstrike, Sharkrum, they're going all onto S4, but again EGM with this shallow grave. He's buying more space and Bulldog goes for more initiation. So S4 is able to survive. The Rubick will go down. So a one-for-one trade-off. Loader into the fight too. Escape, do you still feel you got enough to fight? You burn both your Chronospheres. And Loader could just bring out that refresher orb and get his Metamorphosis back up again in a second as well as his BKB, but the card! Cinderin! He finds the opening! S4! They swap him back out again! So S4 being chased down by the Fawn Spirits, with Alliance breaking three of the three men. Huge curve! But now they're gripped up outside the base. Loader, he wanted a Thunder, but the Lotus Orb cancels it! He doesn't find what he wants, and now he's down for 95 seconds. The buyback will come. He'll actually come back to the front lines with the BT, but how many more of his teammates will still be alive? Here is fighting in the front line. Cinderin goes down. Koifa, they find the damage. They bring him down. Here is on the run too. The sole survivor for escape, but they still have to defend their home. The tier 3 tower is under attack. A rather large wave going in through the top. Alliance have to repair the buildings before they can come out and look for more.
Really scary. You can now jump onto heroes. They'll go right into the Roche pit. And I don't think Secret can contest this one. They're not going to be able to get here in time. Slark's still dead for 3 seconds. They are going to start to move towards the pit. Roche actually falling slower than I thought it would. Our Secret going to be able to contest. BKB gets popped by Bulba. He pulls two up to the high ground. Ramsey's caught by the wall.
Afterlife dead.
Oh, Slark gets him on the backside. We're still looking at Roche. He's still standing. Empire completely committed to this. It will go down to the Dire. Terrible. The one to pick up the Aegis, but it could cost Ramsey's everything. Still hanging on to that Sunder. Oh, Secret. This is bold. Maybe too bold. Envy caught by the Cold Embrace. He'll survive for now. Empire with all 5 alive after the buyback on the Earthshaker. They'll get the kill on Ed. This Magnetize doing so much work. Envy trying to split one way. Pylai dying, Bulba going the other. They are going to go on to Envy. He turns, brings down the Vengeful Spirit before he falls. That
Omelette,
we call it a throwaway item, but he's toggling.
Oh my god.
Secret on the back foot now. Trying to retreat. There's the dunk from Afterlife. Doesn't do a hell of a lot. A buyback's already been used by the puppy. This guy right here. There it is. He pops the Ghost Scepter. He needs to live here. I can't believe Eternal Envy survived through all of that. Armlet toggling, dude. That was some sick, nasty armlet toggling.
Afterlife brought back.
Oh my god, Arteezy, he's getting low, he's getting force stabbed all around, he's completely isolated outside of the base, he gets clipped by the Fissure, Empire trying to isolate him, but Bulba, he's nearby with another great back, now Puppy reinitiates, they go in onto Ramses, remember, he's still got the Aegis of the Immortal, even if they kill him once, he's coming right back, Puppy using this Ghost Scepter so well, Scandal into DB, falls to the Darkseer, Ramses now taking right click to the back from the Spark, that's the Aegis of the Immortal, it'll be down, Maposhka, low on HP, trying to retreat, Puppy somehow still alive, oh my god, Ramses now, can he do this? It's been one long, drawn-out fight. They're going to try to catch Afterlife Puppy. Does he have the Berserker's Call? No, he's going to TP out instead. Looks like this fight will finally start to settle down. And we're going to talk about who actually won that ridiculous exchange. Wow, that's pretty annoying. They force out a Glyph. Spectre does get the Tier 2 tower in the top lane. And now the Elder Dragon form is up. Empire in a great posture here, going right for the sure damage on the ranged barracks. Arise, he's speedy, he's BKB, and he's going on in, he grabs Scandal, that's going to be the target of choice. Afterlife looking for a Ravage, but it's silence after silence. Arise still BKB'd up. Disruptor, the only casualty thus far. There is a pipe on PR that's already been popped, turning into a very spread out fight. Not sure who this is actually favoring. It's a 4v5, and Empire seem to be the ones in full retreat mode, but they've got some ultimates. There's the Ravage, they've still got an Omni Slash. Looks like they won't quite be able to use it. God damn, moves up to the high ground, and now Empire getting chopped a bit. The ult from J4 doing huge damage here. They get Scandal first, now the Omni Slash comes. They try to mech through it, they're all grouped up, and Ramses, with the cleave, picks up a double kill. He'll chase down Arise. They've killed the Bounty, and just like that, PR get pushed back in their own base. The Aegis does go down, Arise trying to drop some fire. Ramses with the Blade Fury cuts him down straight away. Spectre, the lone survivor, now a buyback from Ricky. Ramses says, I'm out of here, boys. I'm heading back to the base. Ranged barracks stay standing low on HP.
Scary. Against Batrider? Like Dyer's taking the positioning inside of the pit.
I'm this grouping up as well. Okay, Atlanta jumping out. 11.
They're gonna scout with a sigil.
So what kind of a jumping they wanna go for? Yang. Okay, Siphon. I mean, just Yang's there. Yang just AFKs it at this point.
Yeah, he does not care at all.
Nice sideline. Okay, Mikasa. He's grabbed Ice. The snowball will come out. Ice is gonna be able to live for it. Next time, Yang. Trying to go on this on the side. The igloo! Oh, trouble! He's
on the shoulder!
Grab the igloo! They'll still play the outside side. Kill N. Still live for it. There's gonna be a comeback from Ice. Mikasa chasing the off. Quarterback comes out. Brawl 11. See Yang and the. See, but they don't have the damage to bring down this Bristleback. Maybe with the ghost they can. Chase it. Come in, but they're on my. Come across. Sticking up here. As Yang still playing around it.
Nice back.
Can they kill them? The Ravage a little bit scared. Jules set up there. Mikasa as well. EGR. He's going to go for the TP out. Yang's arm done. And they said, no, you're not, mate. You're sticking around for this one. Punch to the backside. Yang Nan as well. And Eho. They do it here. Gem hits the deck. They'll pick that one up.
Oh, double kill, you! He almost got the triple!
Oh my god, they were sitting in the Firefly saw because they saw the gem on the ground that when FY came back from his relocate, he got two kills.
Oh my goodness.
Play he's gonna look to make.
A lot of micro, no, that's not Mushi, he's not gonna
do
that.
Not his
style.
Too
much micro.
Okay.
Too much micro.
Just kidding, we're not gonna see that from Mushi. Does what he can to clear. Things out,
swap back on Afu. You talked about mistakes, that's possibly one DJ against Deuce. He dives into the chrono. No Egg, he's getting hit by the Bruise! Oh no! Where's the second chrono? He doesn't even get it off. They're gonna lose the Void as well, and Fnatic are gonna team wipe WG Unity. The Aegis is not gonna amount to match. Aegis says goodbye to his Aegis, as well as his second life. Nana has pulled back, but I think it's gonna be amounting to nada.
Time away to the Juggernaut that he's actually unmanageable because he has such great backup. If they kill the Jug, Bineski is left wide open for TNC for the takings. But if they can't kill him, problem, they've actually ran into EU, who is by himself. There is gonna be the S for the Ravage coming in as well. Refresh at the point as well. There's the double Ravage, Black Ball as well. There is nothing TNC can do.
The Witch Doctor out. They didn't cancel the Witch Doctor out. Let it channel. Wow.
Demon.
He actually got two of them down.
Oh.
No. builds going on. They smoked up themselves, sitting in the high ground, kind of the bit of an unfortunate position. They're gonna go back in, want to finish off this Roche, not leave it. It's kind of low.
They have to finish it before Exorcism runs out. It's the only threat that's keeping escape out.
And it's too late. Yapsa comes in, as you said, they just stack something. Actually, catching it on Tilly.
Oh, we got it.
Comes in on the Quagma. The agent on Kendo will be triggered immediately thanks to the ult slash. That'll be stopped as Yapsa just rolls out. Quagma is still alive somehow. Find some extra control. 2-for-1 so far. They're advising all that as well.
Yapsa comes in. Ages.
Stay alive. Yapsa with the magnetize through so much work with Dara.
He oh, he got one more tick?
Yes,
he's gonna die, right? Yeah, he's dead.
Yeah, okay.
But still.
Bloodbath, man. 4-for-4 at the end.
Kind of afraid, in a way.
If this has to go super late, who are you giving the edge to?
Super late? I think... I mean...
Feel free to qualify with Guinness. Oh, Primal Roar going out on the puppy. Do they have it? Yes, they do. No time to get up that extra arm, but who is coming in? The Fissure way too soon on TZ now with that time dilation, but Era has stunned him up on TZ. Needs some help, but they're just going to knock it down, get a lightning truck. It won't be. The Winter's Curse comes out. They'll kill off that creep, and now a vacuum back on TZ. He could open up with the Chronosphere. Era, he hasn't lost enough mana. He will reincarnate the Timber, the Chakra, causing problems for on TZ, but... they will lose Kezu, and now Era needs some help from Koikva. It is 3v2. How long of the exorcism? Oh yeah, Era, will he turn around and use it? He still hasn't used it. Finally, he pops it there, doing a lot of damage to a Tunnel Envy, but he just doesn't have enough of Koikva. Stunned up there, unable to throw out the Chakram. Never mind, a Tunnel Envy exorcism ends, and she heals right back up.
Bit of a smoke up here in the back lines. Poppy and Pala die look to make something happen.
This is really important to them.
Lori just uses spin.
Well, they don't send Pala die in first though. Maybe not expecting the support to be there.
There it is, with the Surge, there's Disruption, Arcane caught for the and has the kinetic field, but Poppy is on top of him. Running through the damage here, Poison Stacks being done. Comes in and the dunk will be there on the support. And now, Poppy, they're up into the air, but the tower, it doesn't even care about it. Yes, the Unshot on top of him.
Oh the man, this is so good. Poppy, Dota!
More. Loda.
Give it to him!
Shell, a triple dunk, triple kill. Poppy, play with the longest kill streak. Already starting off to a good start. Radiance.
The Ember Spirit went down in their own jungle. Looks like maybe he wasn't expecting it, didn't have a remnant up, but suddenly Era getting his kill on. And that's the power of the Echo Saber, right? That extra attack does make it easier to bring people down. Speaking of, okay, what's going on? He needs help. Doesn't matter. Primal Roar onto Era.
No.
He actually burnt all of his mana, and now Era's going to be slowed up. He pumps the wand to get the pounce up to the high ground. Can Admiral Bulldog do anything here?
No.
The Ember Spirit's coming in. They lose another remnant. There it is. Era, he's in a bit of trouble here. S4 gonna goodness, really?
Yes.
No, he slowed up. He's going, no,
yes.
He pounces away.
Yes,
no way this is happening. And
yes.
S4 still no point in flight of this. He's gonna get black holed up. They have the damage. S4 brought down. What just happened?
S4 should have gotten flight of fist.
Why does he still not have it?
Right here, they know exactly what's going on, who's farming what. They are ready to move into enemy territory and fight if they get a good opportunity.
And they're just not getting any map control for Empire. That's my biggest worry right now. And with all this extra gold coming in from the towers, I mean, look at Bulba now. He's finally
got... Ooh. Look at Puppy! Full man mode. Afterlife says, okay, slam dunk, I'll take that, thank you.
Oh, he's gonna...
Oh my god, dude. That is the dream.
Okay, Puppy's like, you fucking idiot.
Over this mid game. This is definitely the best thing about having an Ursa on your team though, it's just so easy to solo Rosh. Normally teams can kind of play around when they expect their opponents to do it, he's gonna get this in time.
He needs to get this in time, the silence will come out.
The best!
He actually might not get it, they're gonna snatch it with the Aegis going Misery's way. Great Ravage from Mu and they'll take both of them down. Oh my god,
the best!
I can't believe that just happened. Swindles does solo the Winter Wyvern, but that's... That is, almost will call that game losing.
It's a very questionable game of what you want to go for as a Morphling. You probably don't want to go E-Blade because it doesn't scale as well. And there's not that many prime targets to really blow up, but it's so good against Nimbersaw.
Oh, Teezy, he gets stunned out before he can Timber Chain away. Now Silence, will they get in range to zap him down? He goes to the TP, but the Adaptive Strike follows him.
Okay.
Man, Eric! Secret are just getting so greedy on the map. They're trying.
Got reflected back, and he kind of killed his two supports, but that's what they're there for.
I think Leather's actually killing off as many of his own teammates in the fight as he's killing off enemy heroes.
Oh yeah.
Oh, hello. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. He's gonna give up the Mana Thal. The Divine Rapier has arrived. It's still 37 seconds until he's actually got his Metamorphosis up. As they look for a target, EGF, Era, four-staffed up by Syndra, trying to push him away to safety. The Slim Blast will slow down the push, but that damage from Loda is just so high. Radiant's do they go past it? Yeah, they are. They're coming in. They got 40 seconds while this Invoker is down. They're going to go for a straight GG push. Not a single rack has been taken. Fortification will slow it down. Keizu, now back to World of Living. Time walks out. He needs the Chronosphere and he gets it. He isolates Loda, but S4 still causing problems. This Chronosphere, there's no follow-up. Loda at least was controlled, but they don't find the kill. He's going for the fortress with a BKB protecting. Keizu now actually has to go again for the Chronosphere, but he hasn't got enough of them. Now they can just keep attacking it. This could be Elias's game right now, and they've got it! 71 minutes! They actually take it on the back of the Rapier Terrorblade. Elias take game one against Escape after Escape. Looked like they had everything slammed into the bag. They lost it all.